Hi everyone! Okay, so I know I haven't posted for like a month, maybe two, but truth is, college hit me hella hard. Yeah, I was not ready for that at all. Truth is, high school I started getting lazy, you know, senioritis. And yeah, but college hit me hard. I started working at Express. Retail for one thing. So today I am back. The reason I'm back is I finally got a ring light. I was honestly waiting for it because every time I told myself I was gonna film, I was like, oh, let me just wait, because every time I try to film, it was raining or dark outside, so I'm like, I can't film with like no sunlight. So I was like, you know what, let me just buy a ring light, and that way I can film whatever time I have and whatever time I can. So right now it is December, what day is it, 28th, December 28th. So yeah, I'm out of school. I finished on December 19th. So yeah, I don't work today, so I was like, you know what, let me just film this video. So today I'm gonna be recreating my my birthday makeup, because I really like how it came out, whatever. So yeah, so I'm just gonna do a little get ready with me. I'm gonna play some music. Yeah, I'm gonna be talking as I go, hopefully. And I'll fill you guys in on anything special that's going on in my life, any videos I plan on making. And yeah, here we go. So this is my playlist on Spotify. It's my Spanish jams, that's what I called it. But it's mostly like Spanish trap or whatever. Let me know if you guys wanted to see a playlist video. I was planning on doing one like a few weeks ago with my best friend. I wanted to do the Spanish playlist, because I've been listening to a lot. That's what I listen to on my way to school. Forgot to mention what I'm using. I'm using the e.l.f. Daily Hydration Moisturizer. That's what I always use. Hopefully it focused. So yeah, that's pretty much what I always use. It's almost done, honestly. But yeah, that's what I use all the time. Back then I tried the sample of the Marc Jacobs, I think it was, the coconut primer. I think it's Marc Jacobs. Yeah. Because you know, it's just hella expensive. It's like $40-something. So I was like, you know what? Let me get a sample to see if it's actually good on me, because I have dry skin. But yeah, it was pretty good. I think it was good. So I wanna try it out and buy it. So yeah, let me bring this down to my neck, because you know, I'm gonna be putting foundation in this area. Not a lot, but like, you know, a little bit. And then I went in with the Maribou facial spray with aloe and the rose water one. It's clearly some of them. You can tell. I use it like for everything, my hair, my face. Okay. Next I'm going in with the Benefit Polyfessional. So the way I, like, the order I do my makeup has changed a lot since I started. Right now I do my eyebrows first, and then I do my eyeshadow, and then I do my face, because if I do my eyebrows last, I would put concealer over it, and then the concealer is gonna be mad bright. So I rather do my eyebrows before, conceal it, and then put the foundation over it, so that, you know, they're not that bright. So yeah, I'm gonna go in with the NH, the dip brow, and chocolate. That's the shade I like. So the brushes, I use these three brushes. You don't have to use the same exact ones. I just use one that's like a flat brush, and it's like slanted, tilted, whatever. And then this flat like concealer brush, and then, you know, this is like a blending blush, eyeshadow blending blush from NYX. I use that to like blend out the concealer. So yeah, let me bring you guys in closer so you can see the brows. Get that.
so cute, aren't we? So cute, too close, but whatever. Whatever works, you know.
So yeah, I like to, you know, get some and then put it on my hand so that it's not as harsh. Learned that trick from my cousin, actually. Alba. I call her Loli. I don't know if she's watching this. She better though, because I'll call her. So yeah, I just lined the top first and then the bottom to like shape them. That's how I've always done them. And then I fill them in and I go back sometimes into what I put on my hand because, you know, this shit is thick, so it's still there. So yeah, that's what I do. I ran out from like months ago. And, you know, just brush it out a little so that it looks like, you know, so not just fully drawn on and shit and whatnot. So yeah, that's that. I'm gonna go in with the brow gel. It's a clear brow gel from Anastasia. And just set the brows. Don't put too much because then you have like all this like gel on your eyebrows and it's not cute. You feel me? And this is a way to like comb out your eyebrows into whatever shape you want them to actually look like. And believe it or not, you get to see your real eyebrows more. You know? No. So now I go in with my Tarte shade tape. I'm in the shade Tan Sand. I don't know if you guys can see me. I think you can, but I like to tilt my head so I can see clearly. So yeah, I just carve it on the bottom and carve it on the top. I used to do my whole top eyebrow like from the beginning, but I feel like now I like that faded look on the top. And then I used to like box them, but it's not good because it looks boxed. So yeah, I do that and then I go in with the eyeshadow brush and just blend it all. I never memorized that part. Oh my god. So yeah, back with the shade tape. I'm gonna try to go like this, but yeah, go my eyelid. This shit is strong, so don't put too much, like me. And then back with the eyeshadow. Then using the same brush, I go into my Anastasia Modern Renaissance. Dirty as hell, I know. Dirty as hell, oh my god. Yeah, see this? This is like my color, bro. The burnt orange, it's like dead. So yeah, I go to Tempera, which is also dead, which is this one right here. With the other side of the brush that I did not use. And then I use it to set my concealer. Tap it off because hella pigmented. So yeah, I set it with that. I always like to go in with the lighter shade because it's not the transition color. This is just to set it, so you need it a bright color. It doesn't have to be bright, but this is just what I prefer. Because it's also good because I bring it all the way to the brow, so then I get to brighten the brow, you feel me? So yeah, burnt orange. Transition shade. And the transition shade is basically the first shade you apply so that all the other shades that go after it like blend good. And this is also like the base, basically. Like, it's like priming a wall. Not really. It's like the first shade that you put so that everything else can look better on top of it. Like, you know, so you can build everything up good. Next, I'm going to go in with red ochre. And then on top of a Venetian red. So those are the two colors that I used on my outer corner. So first with red ochre in the outer, and like just blends it all out. And I'm using a Morphe brush from the, I don't even know what it's called. It was like a rose gold collection with like 12 brushes. I'll try to find it. I know the last time I looked, they didn't have it anymore. So I'll check, and if not, I'll just show a picture of it or the name, and hopefully if it comes back, you guys will know what I'm talking about. But I've definitely used this before, and I've talked about it before in my, I think it was in my haul. I need like a blending brush, so I'm gonna just use this. It's not really a blending brush, but it has like brown eyeshadow on it, but I'm gonna just do it to both sides just in case. But I like blending on like the end because I feel like it always looks like harsh. Even though it's been here for like hours blending. Well, it's a Venetian red now. It's not really a red. I feel like it's like a pink. That's what I liked. And then the color I used in the inner corner, I feel like it was so unique because I mixed two colors together. And I feel like it's made everything look so much better. Back into tempera. Or any shade you have. And, you know, just boom. Too high. Don't know why, but you know, boom. If you want to be more precise with it, go into a precise brush, you know, smaller one, detailed. But I don't really care right now, so that, don't mind the edges. I'm gonna clean that up with concealer. Yeah, so dirty, you see it's dirty, right? Because she decides to come out with a new packaging after I buy it. And then I have my colors here to make it easier for myself. I haven't used this palette forever though. But if I, oh yeah, I almost forgot which colors I used. But I wanted to use this color, so I used that color right here. What is it called? Cranapple. That's cool. And then Angie really loved this color right here, so I went into it. It's called Queen. I didn't even notice, but that's what made the look like, you know? The inner corner. Boom. Color's so nice. But yeah, I really wanted a pink look, but of course I needed something on top of it to make it like pop a little more, you feel me? So that's that, right? And then I go on top of it with Queen because it makes it look like green and like money and like gold and like, you know? You know? There's another color that I really love. It's called Sissy. It's this one. Sissy, whatever. S-I-S-S-O-I. And it's really pretty because it's like pink and gold together, which is what I could have done, but it's like a lighter pink, and I wanted to keep that, like, you know, like diva pink going on, you know? So yeah, mix those two together, and that's how I got like this look. To some of you, I could have just done the Queen alone, but I feel like it gives it that pink undertone that I was looking for. So yeah, I'm gonna go to Too Faced Born This Way. I'm in the shade Honey. So let me spray the beauty blender again. This is a trick to make it go in a little, you know, smoother, brighter, more moisturizing. But yeah, not all dry skin are gonna like it. I'm not, you know? Like, I have a friend, my best friend, she doesn't like it. Maybe she will if she tries it with a better moisturizer. But you just gotta work around with it and play around with it and find whatever works for you. So yeah, like I said, just to make sure you don't put too much, pump a little and then add more if you need to add more. I'm gonna do half of them because it's only my forehead and I don't need to put that much because I hate when it gets in my hair because that's annoying. It's my song. Dance is coming soon. Get ready. That's another thing. I've wanted to do dance routines, but I don't know if you guys would be interested in that, so let me know. See, I go in with a Tarte shape tape. So do both sides like this because shit is really pigmented. Pigmented, whatever. And then a little down the nose. And then blend it all the way out. So yeah, that's that, and then I go in and study with all the Kat Von D shading. Like, I usually use the Bed 9, but now I've been using this. I use the middle shade, this one to highlight, and this one to contour. So first, I go in with a brush like this from the Morphe collection thingy, brush set that I got. This is my favorite song. Like, I don't know why, but it is. So yeah, I go into the middle highlighting shade. I don't like put too much because I feel like it brightens it a little too much sometimes. And I'm like, don't want all that brightness. I don't want to look like a ghost. You know? Anoche me acordé con otra. Tu sexo sentido no se equivoca. Cuando le miento, baby, lo siento. Anoche me acordé con otra. Mamá sin ropa. A little more in the center of my face to brighten here because I don't really put concealer. Because I don't like brightening it too much, but yeah, why not? This is damn pimple. And this is where I really get dry. Smile line. Good. Now, first, before going into the contour, I go in with the Hoola bronzer because I like to warm up my face first. I don't know why, I just do. I don't really use cream contour that much. Maybe one day I will, but I feel like it's too much time. I take too much time on it. I use the LA Girl Pro Concealer, but it's like, the one I use Toast, is too like dark, so a little goes a long way, and like really blends it out good. So if you don't know how to find it, just, you know, match the top of your ear and go down. I'm being really messy with it because I'm going to go back in with the highlighting powder later on and like carve it out, so I don't really care. And then on my chin, my brolic ass chin, not really brolic as fat. So now I'm gonna go to the Kat Von D contour palette again and go into this shade. It's called Shadow Play. I think it's cute. So Lyric and Shadow Play are the ones I use. The same brush though. Tapping off. He's cooking. Is it me or does it look like I already got highlight on, even though I don't? Crazy. By the way, that's a W. You're not getting a shout out. You know who you are. Oh, and before the camera shut off, I was contouring, not really contouring, but bronzing my collarbone and then the chest area. I do this, I don't know why, but yeah. It's not really contour because I just go, I just believe this. So it's not like I'm doing much, but yeah. And then don't forget the nose contour. I don't do much nose contour either because when I do my makeup like this, to go out, I always plan ahead and I take forever, so I don't really have time to do the proper nose contour, so this is just what I do. Yeah. Gucci. And then maybe here a little sometimes, you know. Okay, so that's that. Next, I'm gonna go into the blush. This is the Tarte blush. I haven't tried any one. This is the first one. It's called Partey. Partey, as it is spelled. It's the Amazonian Clay Flower blush. I got this from the birthday thing from Sephora. I don't know if it's actually sold. I would assume it is. But the thing about blushes, I don't really use blushes like that, but I wanted to try them out. So I dip into it. I feel like I didn't even put much on my birthday. And then I just, with a big fluffy brush. Cause I don't really like that much. So there you go. Next, I go in with the highlight. Glow Kit. Glowing. Boom. I go into tourmaline, which is this one over here. It's my favorite one. It's like a rose gold, but it's like a purpley rose gold. So I really like how it looked, and I wanted to continue that pink trend. So a little trick I learned, I was watching Shay Mitchell's YouTube video. She did a video with Ariel, the makeup artist. And I was like, he told her something that I was like, bro, like, it's common sense. But I've always heard that highlight, like, you know, find the top of your cheekbones and then highlight away. But then he was saying that, you know, actually highlight a little under it. Not right, like, on top, because that's what I used to do it. And then it gives it a better look, you know? And then, yeah. Boom. And then, you know, curve right here so you can be, glow master. So yeah, I really like that color. And if you want a wet look, you know, just spray it. But I don't really feel like spraying it. Maybe I'll spray it later because sometimes I feel like I'm like, this is not enough highlight, but bitch, yes it is. Angel, what do you want?
What is wrong with this today?
Why? Is it optimum Wi-Fi?
Look.
It's fine.
Then why is it still loading?
I don't know. Start it over. Yeah. I highlighted basically more. So my cheekbones, my chin, my cupid's bow, my nose, and my eyebrow. I'm going back into the highlighting palette and I'm going to clean up the contour with the same shade from earlier. Make sure to bring it down so that this whole area here gets brighter because you're only supposed to contour this part. So, you know, bring it out here a little. Make sure you're brushing it off so that you don't get the, like, harsh line. Not harsh line, but, like, you know, a shadow. Hard. My lips are like so dry. Like, I need to get an exfoliator because it's really bad and I need to wipe off that. Sometimes I don't, so that's what makes it worse. Okay, so that's good. So I'm gonna like put some on the edge of my nose so that the contour is like more like, you know, present. Shows more so you can see it more and shit. And then just bring it down. Okay, this is why I never do it because I never put it on the tip.
There you go.
And then just wipe it off right away. Because again, we don't want that to be extremely bright, you know? Just a little brightness, but not like excessive. I'm pretty much done, but I just need my lashes and lipstick. So I go into the Estee Lauder Sumptuous Extreme Lash Multiplying Volume Mascara. Honestly, this is my favorite because it gives me volume and it fills it in good, but I never got around to buying the full size. I just be stealing the samples from my mother. Thanks, Mom. So yeah, let me put this up a little. So this is how I do it. The one part of makeup that I never have done because I never get it right is lashes. Like, I don't know how you guys do it. One day I'll learn, hopefully. But for right now, until I do, I feel like my natural lashes aren't that bad. So I can be good for now. But one day, man, one day, I will learn. Now, I haven't done eyeliner because the one I have is dry. I have the NYX one. Like, it's really good, but it dries a lot quicker, I'm assuming, than others. That's the only one I really like use or whatever. Get a makeup wipe and wipe my lipstick off. Well, not lipstick though. Excess foundation. Because it's not Gucci. That's just all dryness, so it's not good for you to place product on top of dry skin. So I go into MAC World to line my lips. Overline it a little, but whatever. And then I'm going to Kat Von D Lolita. I really like it. It's like the perfect pink. So wait for it to dry and then apply gloss. So yeah, I'm gonna apply my gloss when it dries. It's the Dose of Colors. It's like almost gone. Like, it's really almost gone. It's like the most beautiful gloss ever. It's the over the top gloss by Desi and Katie in collaboration with Dose of Colors. I love it. It's sold out. It was like limited edition. I hope they bring it back because I need it in my life. I wanted to get an extra one, but I was broke, so like I couldn't. I forgot to highlight my collarbone, so I'm gonna do that right now when my lipstick dries. It's so cold in my room because I opened the window, because I know that since I have the ring light on, it would be best to open the window just in case it gets hot, because I get hot really quickly and that's not good. But yeah, and then some of my shoulder. So this was like a semi get ready with me because I talked to you guys for a bit. I talk more than I usually do on here, which I feel like it's good. So yeah, I hope you really guys enjoy it. Let me know if you like this kind of video. I like it because I get to take my time and talk to you guys and inform you on what's been going on because it's been crazy. I really talk about college that much because I really want to talk about it in that video I told you guys I wanted to make, the what to expect video, so that's why I didn't really talk about it as much. But so yeah, I live in New York. I go to a CUNY, which is just a city school in New York, in the city. And it's really different, but I have some friends that go to like out of state, like my friend Angie goes to SUNY New Paltz. My other best friend, she goes to a private school in New York, so she gets that like on campus vibe because they have a campus. So I wanna do the video with them. Hopefully they can come, and yeah, we talk about school struggles we went through. So lastly, I'm gonna go to Dose of Colors, the gloss, because I wore gloss on my birthday, and I really love it because it has like glitter on it. And it's like so cute and cool. And it's like the perfect gloss. So that's pretty much it. Lastly, setting spray. You can use this as a setting spray, but usually not really. It's just like to moisturize your skin and like refresh it. It's not really a setting spray, but it works. Anything works, you know, anything that works for you. I just like it because it like brings back the moisture into my skin. So yeah, that's the last up, I think. I hope I don't miss anything. Yeah, okay, here we go. Guys, I hope you enjoyed it because I really love how it turned out. Pink is definitely my color. Hope you guys enjoyed. And until next time, bye. Not touching my lips because what? But.